Welcome into the poker room. Grab yourself a drink and perch yourself up on the rail as we talk some wingman poker. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome on into this edition of Wingman Poker Presents On The Rail. I'm your host, Michael Furley, and as always, I'd like to thank all of you for watching this show. This is our first On The Rail episode of the 2024 season, and the first On The Rail episode ever to be posted onto our YouTube channel. In this show, we will be going over the Wingman Poker Opening Day Classic, so pour your favorite drink, grab a snack, nestle in, and join me on the rail. All right, rail birds, in this show, we will be going over upcoming events, league standings, and recap the last tournament. We have now concluded the first of seven of our regular season tournaments, and it is time to recap the Wingman Poker Opening Day Classic. All right, guys, in this tournament, we had nine players, and all nine players did RSVP, earning themselves a nice $250 chip bonus. As always, our starting stacks were $1,500 in chips, and this time we did have two players who needed to rebuy, as Patty DeVille and Diane, the Mother of Dragons, needed to replenish their chips during the rebuy window. With all that said, with the buy-ins, rebuys, and add-ons, there were a total of $18,250 worth of chips sloshing around in this last tournament. And with the buy-ins and rebuys, it created a tournament prize pool of $220. The top two finishers would earn payouts this time around, as first place would take home $143, while second place would take home $77. All right, guys, for those poker addicts, it is time to get into our players' hands. I've highlighted approximately 17 hands from the last tournament for your viewing and scouting pleasure. So with all that being said, let's get into some of the poker. All right, let's take a look at the lineups for the opening day classic. On table A, in seat one, we have Chris M, the Scorpion King. In seat two, we have Diane W, the Mother of Dragons. In seat three, we have Patty K, a.k.a. Patty DeVille. In seat four, we have Jordan R, Jurassic Jordan. And in seat five, we have Michael F, Amazing Spidey. All right, now let's take a look at our players that are over on table B. In seat one on table B, we have Gerhardt W, the Austrian Assassin, followed by Scott H, a.k.a. 710. In seat three, we have Stephen S, the Doom Slayer. And in seat four, we have Alicia M, the Scorpion Queen.
Let's get ready to shuffle. Shuffle up and deal.
All right, let's do a quick pause real quick just to set this table. Now that you can see a visual representation, our dealer is going to be Scott, a.k.a. 710. He's in the top left corner. Our small blind will be the Doom Slayer. That's Stephen S. on the top right corner. Big blind will be the Scorpion Queen on the bottom right corner. And first to act will be the Austrian Assassin on the bottom left corner. We're on the first blind level at 25 and 50. All right, let's pick up the action. First to act will be Gerhardt, the Austrian Assassin, who looks down at a queen. Queen nine suited of diamonds. He makes the call. We have Scott makes the quick fold over to the Doom Slayer, who looks down at an offsuit. King five, king of clubs, five of diamonds. Costs him 25 to fill this up if he wants to continue to play. He does so, and we have a check from our big blind, the Scorpion Queen, who looks at a jack 10 offsuit. All right, the flop comes out. Eight, four of diamonds with a two of clubs. So right now, high card is going to take it. Although we do have a flush draw from Gerhardt, the Austrian Assassin. First to make the move here will be the Doom Slayer. He checks. So does the Scorpion Queen, and it checks all the way around. So the turn comes out. Jack, the Scorpion Queen hits the top pair of a jack. So we have a pair of jacks versus the flush draw and the king high card from the Doom Slayer. It looks so the Doom Slayer will be first act here. He checks. And oh, we have a little slow player from the Scorpion Queen who also checks. So it checks around to the river and a five of club comes out. The Doom Slayer checks over to the Scorpion Queen who bets out 100. Gerhardt, the Austrian assassin, folds as he does not catch his diamond flush. But now it's over to the Doomslayer, who did connect on a pair of fives. So he's going to pay this one off to see if his pair of fives is good. The total pot's 250. And the pair of jacks from the Scorpion Queen takes this one down. A nice little pot to start the tournament off. All right, now we're going to move over to our next hand, and we're going to shift over to table A for this one. Let me pause real quick to set this table. All right, we're going to have our dealers in the top left. That is Patty DeVille. Small blind will be Jurassic Jordan. Big blind will be Amazing Spidey on the bottom right side. First to act will be the Scorpion King on the bottom left. And then on the end of the table on the left side is the Mother of Dragons. So first act is Chris the Scorpion King, who quickly folds over to the Mother of Dragons, who looks down at a suited 8 ace 6 clubs. She makes the call. Patty DeVille also makes the call. It's going to be 25 more to play, but he folds, Jurassic Jordan does, and Amazing Spidey looks down at a 3-2 offsuit, and he checks his big blind, and we are off to the flop. Flop comes out 6-8-8, so there's a pair on the board, and the Mother of Dragons has the next pair, so she flops 2 pair. Amazing Spidey's trying to protect his big blind, bets out 100. Over to the Mother of Dragons, who has a very strong hand to start with. But it will be 100 to make the call for the Mother of Dragons, who has two pair with an ace kicker. And she does make the call over to Patty DeVille. 100 for her to make the call. She decides to fold. So we're down to two players. Pot's at 375. The next card, the turn, comes out as a king of spades. And we have Amazing Spidey leading out with 200 with nothing. He's doing a stone cold bluff trying to protect his big blind. But the 200 bet does give the Mother of Dragons pause, who has two pair, and the strong kicker. But she's worried about maybe a pocket pair bigger than a 6, maybe an 8, or king. Anything else, she's good. There's only a backdoor flush draw to worry about, really. So that's all she's worried about, is pocket pairs bigger than a 6 or an 8. She does make the call, so the pot's up to 775. Amazing Spidey is on a stone cold bluff. The queen comes out. Doesn't help either of their hands. No flush draws to be had. Amazing Spidey is going to fire another bullet. Leads out with 400 this time. Or 350, rather. And Mother Dragons makes the call. Sees that Amazing Spidey was bluffing. And she takes a big pot early in the tournament, just on holding strong and not letting the bluff take it down. Great call from the Mother of Dragons, and a very nice pot early in this tournament. All right, we are back over to table B. Our dealer is Gerhardt, the Austrian assassin. Small blind is Scott H, 710. Big blind is the Doomslayer, and first to act will be the Scorpion Queen, who does fold. Over to Gerhardt, who's looking down at an ace, 10 offsuit, ace of clubs, 10 of spades. He does make the call over to 710. Who also makes the call. And we have a check from the big blind, the Doomslayer, and he looks down at a jack queen offsuit. All right, so here comes the flop. The flop is 3, jack queen. The Doomslayer leads out with 2 pair, and he is first to act on this round. So let's see if he tries to slow play it or gets his money in early while he knows he's good. He does check. It checks around, giving Gerhardt a free card. And Gerhardt gets the card he's waiting for. The King of Spades comes out. So now he has an ace high straight. Doomslayer is still first to act, and he's a little he has his top pair, or two pair rather. He leads out with a modest bet of 50, trying to get a feeler to see if Gerhardt hit with that nice flop. Gerhardt raises to 150, so it'll be 100 more to call. Scott folds this time around. Sorry about that. 100 more to call. He does call with his two pair. Going to the river, a 3 of clubs. So now there is a pair on the board. So Doomslayer has 3 pairs, queens, jacks, and threes, while the ace high straight is still the best hand. We have a check from the Doomslayer. Now it's over to... Actually, he leads out with 200. Quick call from Gerhardt, the Austrian assassin. He flips over his ace 10 to show his ace high straight, which beats the two pair of queens and jacks. A nice hand from Gerhardt, getting $850. in chips. All right, we're heading back over to table A. Our dealer is Chris M. the Scorpion King. Small blind is the Mother of Dragons. Big blind is Patty DeVille. First to act will be Jurassic Jordan. Jurassic Jordan makes the call. We have Amazing Spidey folds. We now have a raise from the Scorpion King. He raises 200. So we have a fold from the Mother of Dragons, a call from Patty DeVille, and a call from Jurassic Jordan. So we have three players in this pot. The pot is up to 625. First to act now will be Patty DeVille, but the flop is a 10-6 Queen of Hearts. It's a little hard to see, so we're going to put the little label up here to help you guys see. So 10 of clubs, 6 of clubs, Queen of Hearts, Scorpion King flops top pair. The table checks around, and he bets. What does he bet there? Is that 650? He does. He bets 650. Now it's back to Patty DeVille. Remember, this checked around to the race, to the big lead-out bet. She's counting chips. She makes the call. Jurassic Jordan folds. We have a monster pot of 1925. The turn comes out as an ace of clubs. So now let's see what we got here. We have a club draw for the Scorpion King. He still has second pair now, and he does have a straight draw. King gives him a straight. Club gives him a flush. A club comes out, so he has a flush, a ace-high flush with the queen as the second card. He has to be worried about a king of clubs. That would take it.
1 minute remaining.
Scorpion King leads out with 800 after a check. I have no idea what Patty has here, but she makes the call, and she's going to be all in. She's less than the bet, so she put in 650. She is all in. Only a king of clubs would have beat him, and she did not have it. So the ace high flush with the queen as the second card takes a big pot of 3225, a monster pot. Sends Patty out to the ATM. If she wants to stay and play, she'll have to pay, and she's going to rebuy to stay in this tournament. Oh, my goodness. All right, she did rebuy, so we still have the same number of players in the tournament. We have 9 players still in this tournament. We are now back to table B. Our dealer is the Scorpion Queen. Small blind is the Austrian Assassin. Big blind is Scott H. 710, who looks down at a king queen offsuit, and first to act will be the Doom Slayer. Doom Slayer folds over to Alicia M, the Scorpion Queen, who looks down at a suited ace, ace nine of clubs. She does. She raises to 200. If you didn't notice, our blinds are now up at the 5100 mark. We have the small blind folds. Scott makes the call. So we have a nice pot here of 450 with two players. Ace nine versus queen, king, queen, and a king comes out on the first card. So we have a king, three, jack. So we have a pair of kings is the best hand at the moment. Let's see, what did she lead out there? She led out, I don't know, I don't have it here. 850. She let out 200. He made the call at 200. Now the next card is a 10 of clubs. So let's see. She has a flush draw, and Scott still has the top pair of a king, and he has a straight draw. First to act here will be Scott. They check around to the turn. A 9 comes out. So now he has the straight. Is that right? 9, 10, jack, queen, king. Yeah. Okay. He went from top pair to a straight. They each bet 300. Making a nice pot of 1450, and Scott takes this one down. He went from strong to stronger, although a club would have been a disastrous card for Scott. But he does take this one down. A nice pot for Scott H. All right, back over to table A. Just a little set the table here. We have a new rule this year. The first player who has to rebuy their secondary chip is the donkey chip. This is nothing personal, just the rule this year. The first player to rebuy into the tournament will get the donkey chip. So it's still Patty DeVille in the top left corner here. Our dealer is the Mother of Dragons on the left side. Small blind is Patty DeVille. Big blind is Jurassic Jordan. Small first act will be Amazing Spidey, who looks down at a pair of sixes. Blinds here are 5,100 as well. Amazing Spidey raises with a pair of sixes. Oh, that's a little risky move there, but he raises the 200, so it's over to the Scorpion King, who then folds over to the Mother of Dragons, who has a suited ace, ace two of spades. There'll be 200 to make the call. She does make the call over to Patty DeVille, who's already in for the small blind, but she looks like she's going to... I'm not sure. Patty DeVille folds her small blind. Now over to Jurassic Jordan, who's looking at a monster pocket pair of queens. He only makes the call as there was a raise in front of him, looking to catch these guys later. The flop comes out ace, six, eight. So Mother of Dragons catches top pair while the Amazing Spidey hits his set of sixes. And Jurassic Jordan leads out with a check, not liking the overcard. And we have an all-in. Amazing Spidey bets all of his chips of 500 to make the total pot 1150. While the Mother of Dragons does have top pair, and she quickly makes the call, getting this up to 1650. What is Jurassic Jordan going to do with these pocket queens? He lays them down. Oh, what a brilliant lay down. What a great move. He won't know it right away, but he'll see it when they flip the cards over. He was behind. He was third out of three. A three of hearts comes out. No help. Jack of spades would have helped Jurassic Jordan, even if he did stay in. The set of sixes hold. 666. The devil's hand takes this one down. And Amazing Spidey is able to double up.
You get pocket aces a lot when you play.
Wow. Big time hand from Amazing Spidey. All right, we're back over to table B. Our dealer is Scott on the top left. Small blind is the Doomslayer. Big blind is the Scorpion Queen. First act would be Gerhardt, the Austrian Assassin, who does make the fold. And we have a raise here. We have a raise here from Scott H, who's a dealer. He bets 275 as he looks down at suited queen, king of diamonds. So it is over to the Doomslayer. So it'll be he's already in for the small blind. So, which was 50. So it'd be two and a quarter to stay in. But he raises all in. He only had a little bit more. So it's a total of 325. Scorpion Queen folds. We have a quick call from Scott. So they both have queens. So it's king versus five, clubs versus diamonds. No one hits their pair, but the clubs come out. We have two clubs, one more club. Oh, a five hits. Pair of fives is in the lead right now, and a club draw. Oh, let's make it even stronger. A set of fives to finish out this hand. Started off well behind, but comes back with a vengeance. The Doom Slayer gets a nice pot of 750 and survives an all-in. Wow. All right, back over to table A. We have the dealer is Jurassic Jordan. Small blind is Amazing Spidey. Big blind is the Scorpion King. First to act will be the Mother of Dragons, who looks down at a super strong pocket pair of tens. Will she call or fold? She just makes the call. Oh, she actually raised the 200. I could be mistaken here. No raises. We just have the calls here. So we have four players in a pot of 400. The flop comes out. King, five, eight. Once again, Amazing Spidey flops his low pair set. He gets a set of fives. He's counting the pot just to see how much he wants to put in. So we have a set of fives versus a pair of tens. He bets 600. Scorpion King makes a quick fold. It's going to be 600 to call from the Mother of Dragons. There are two spades out there, so she does have the higher spade draw, even though it's going to take a lot of spade, a spade on the turn and the river. Oh, she's got to think she's good here. She's just worried about a king. She does make the call. The pot fills up to 1,600 total over to Patty DeVille. Patty DeVille makes the fold, so we're down to two players in this hand. $1,600 the pot. The queen of clubs comes out, so the set is still strong. Let's see. Yep, there's no straight draws for her either, so she is so behind, she doesn't even know. She has two over cards. She's worried about Amazing Spidey, although she got bluffed early, so you can see why she would make calls when this when the Spidey keeps leading out. He bets 700. Pots up to 2,300. It'll be 700 to call. She's going to make the call. She didn't quite, so she's actually going all in. She's calling. She had six. She had six hundred. So Spidey's going to pull one back. So we have a set of fives versus a pair of tens, and the Mother of Dragons is all in. The seven of clubs comes out, not enough to help. She needed a 10 and a 10 alone. And once again, Amazing Spidey catches the Mother of Dragons with a low pair, pocket pair, hitting the set on the flop. Not fair. Strong hand, $2,800 in chips. Huge pot. And with that, the Mother of Dragons is going to have to pay to stay. If she wants to keep the play, she's going to go to the ATM and she's going to rebuy to stay in this tournament. All right, we're staying here at table A. We have the, let me just pause it real quick. So the Mother of Dragons is still on the left side of the table, but now she has her secondary bounty disc and she had to rebuy the Black Widow bounty disc. So we are still, the blinds are now up though to 75-150. We're at table A. The dealer is Jurassic Jordan. Small blind is Amazing Spidey. Big blind is the Scorpion King. And first to act will be the Mother of Dragons, who looks down at an ace nine offsuit. All right, what is the Mother of Dragons going to do? She does make the call. Oh, we have a raise all in from Patty the poker. Oh, sorry, Patty DeVille, who looks down at a queen jack offsuit. I think she raised 375. We have a fold from Jurassic Jordan, a fold from Amazing Spidey, and now we have the big blind, the Scorpion King, who's looking down at an 8-10 offsuit. He makes the call. The flop comes out 6-7 queen. Sorry for the little pause here. I'm just trying to get myself caught up here. So we have an 8-10. So we have a 6-7 queen. So we have Patty DeVille flopping top pair. The turn comes out nine of diamonds. So now the Mother of Dragons has a second pair of nines. She has a nut flush draw. The action is over. And oh, the Scorpion King now has, he has a straight. He has a 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He hit the straight with that nine of diamonds. So he's going to lead out 400. Over to the Mother of Dragons, who has a second pair and a flush draw. She makes the call. And the river comes out. That is a jack of clubs. Oh my gosh. So now we have a seven card straight for the Scorpion King. He has 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Jack, queen. He has a seven card straight. The Mother of Dragons has a middle pair. Needed a diamond badly. He puts the Mother of Dragons all in. We have a pot of 2250. 2575. Oh my gosh, he got the double knockout. Oh, my goodness. And they both already rebought, so they are out for the tournament. Oh, my. Huge pot for the Scorpion King. He sends both Patty DeVille and the Mother of Dragons off to the rail. Huge hand and huge outcome for the Scorpion King. All right, quick pause here. So now we are still in the same blind level of 75-150, but with those two players eliminated, we are now going to combine to one table, our final table, although the rebuy period is still open for a few more minutes. So everything's shuffled around here. So let's just go through this real quick. On the bottom left in seat one, we still have Chris, the Scorpion King, but on the left side, we have the Scorpion Queen. Top left, we have Jurassic Jordan. Top right, we have Amazing Spidey. On the right, top right corner, we have the Doomslayer. On the right side, we have Austrian Assassin. And on the bottom right, we have Scott H, a.k.a. 710, and he is the dealer. So the small blind is the Scorpion King. Big blind is Scorpion Queen. First to act will be Jurassic Jordan. Jurassic Jordan makes the call. Amazing Spidey with a quick fold over to the Doomslayer, who also folds, and now to the Austrian Assassin, who does fold as well. Scott H looks down at an ace six suited of spades. He makes the call. We have a fold from the Scorpion King and a check from our big blind. So we have three players in this hand. The flop comes out 9, 10, 8. We have an 8, 9, 10 on the board, two spades. So we have a pair of eights from the Scorpion Queen. We have a flush draw and a straight draw from Scott H. The Scorpion Queen will be the first to make a move here. She bets 400 to go all in. We got a fold from Jurassic Jordan, a quick call from Scott 710. The jack comes out. They should be able to flip their cards over. Yeah, they did flip their cards over. So now we have a jack here. 8, 9, 10 jack. There are four cards in a row. Does she have a straight now? She does have a straight. Oh, wow. So she went from top middle pair to a straight, and all Scott needed was a spade, but it did not come out. So the Scorpion Queen survives her all in, getting 1325 and chips. Scott just couldn't, he had so many outs and just couldn't get that catch. All right, as you hear, that's the horn. So this is the last hand of the rebuy window before we go to break. So let's see here. Our dealer is Jurassic Jordan. Small blind is Amazing Spidey. Big blind is the Doomslayer. First to act is Gerhardt the Austrian Assassin. Austrian Assassin folds over to Scott H, who folds. Now it's over to the Scorpion King, who looks down at an ace, five offsuit, ace of spades, five of diamonds. It'll be 200 to play. He makes the call. Over to the Scorpion Queen, who folds. Jurassic Jordan folds. Now to the small blind Amazing Spidey. Will he fill it up or just let it fold here? They kind of made change of the table. He's already in for 100, even though there's 50 in front of him, because they made, they combined their bets with the Doomslayer there. So it's 100 to play for Spidey. He does fold. Option over to the Doomslayer if he wants to make it bigger, or we can play from here with 500 in the pot. All right, the Doomslayer is looking down at a jack of diamonds. I cannot see his second card, so we're just going to play it from here with the best we got. Here comes the flop. 10. King. King. All right, so we have two kings and a 10 on the board. First act will be the Doomslayer, who has a jack, so he's got a straight draw. As does Scott, as does Chris, who has an ace. So it's the Doomslayer's choice if he wants to lead out or check. All right, he's all in for 225, and we have a call from Chris, who has so many chips, he's willing to just see what he got here. Oh, a jack comes out, so we have a pair of jacks. Ace high was good prior to that. Now an eight comes out, no flushes caught. The pair of jacks holds on. So once again, the Doomslayer survives an all-in. It was chump change for the Scorpion King to make the call, but 950, a solid pot for the Doomslayer to survive and stay in a little bit longer. All right, so we are back from break. Now the blinds are up to 150, 300. Our dealer is in the top right, the Doomslayer. First to act, small blind is Austrian Assassin. Big blind is Scott 710. And first to act will be the Scorpion King, who looks down at an ace jack offsuit. Very strong hand. Ace of diamonds, jack of spades. He raises to 900, coming out strong. We have a fold from the Scorpion Queen, a fold from Jurassic Jordan, a fold from Amazing Spidey, and the Doomslayer looking down at a suited ace. Ace, eight of spades. He's counting chips. He makes the call. Pots up to 2250. Over to Scott 710, who looks down at another suited jack eight. Jack eight of hearts. I don't know if you can hear him right here or not, but he would have folded in normal circumstances, but with a suited straight draw and a chance to triple up as he's medium in chips, he's going to take a shot here, I think, at just trying to get the most bang for his buck, regardless of the actual winning percentage here. But the value of the bet is worth as much as anything else. So he's going to actually raise all in, which was 1025. So the pot is now up to 3100 even. So it's only a 1.25 to make the call. Chris does that. And so does the Doomslayer. So we have three players in this pot. 3225 is the total. We make a little change for these guys. We still have two active bettors in the Doomslayer and the Scorpion King. Scott's going to have to watch. He's put his chip in. He is all in. All right, here comes the flop. Spade. Club. A little sloppy. We'll fix it. And another spade. So we have two spades for the Doomslayer. We had an exposed burn card of a two of hearts. So we have a 6-2-7 on the board. Two of those are spades. The ace jack is still ahead of the moment, but the spade draw is strong. So they check around to the turn. Oh, another mishandle. That's okay. It's okay. But we did have a mishandle. Queen of clubs, the black, but not the spade. So a five of diamonds is exposed as another burn. So over to the Doomslayer if he wants to bet or not. All right, so they check right there. Going to the turn. Going to the river, rather. Nine of clubs, another black card, but not a spade. So the ace with the jack kicker. Looks like it's going to play. Scott missed everything. No red cards at all. No jack, and even that, he would have won. Yeah, he was actually dominated. Eight wouldn't have been good for him because he would have been taken by the ace kicker. A jack would not be good for him because he would have been taken by the ace kicker. So the ace high with the jack as the second highest card other than the queen of the board takes the pot. Oh, we have a knockout as Scott H has been eliminated. A fatality for Chris M. We're going to start calling him the Lawn Mower Man as he just keeps mowing down players and raking in chips. So we're down to six players at this table as Scott has been eliminated. All right, our dealer is the Scorpion King. Small blind is the Scorpion Queen. Big blind is Jurassic Jordan. First to act will be Amazing Spidey, who quickly folds over to the Doomslayer on the top right corner. Looks like he folds as well. The Austrian Assassin looks down at a suited queen nine of diamonds. He makes the call. And then we have a raise from the Scorpion King. Looks down at a king queen offsuit. Puts 900 in. So we have both blinds folding. It's going to be 600 more to call for the Austrian Assassin. He makes the call. We have a pot up to 20-250. Two players, both have queens. The flop comes out, queen, king, seven. So we have top pair of queens. He goes all in. Let's see, what was that? That was kind of a quick thing here. So we had a raise to go all in. And now, so the pot is the 46.75. Gerhardt is the one who is all in here as he has a straight draw and a flush draw. He just needs a 10 or a diamond. And he is in good shape with the top pair of kings is in charge right now. Here comes the river, a black eight. He needs a 10 or a diamond. It does not come out. Two pair for the scorpion king who gets kings and sevens. Oh my gosh. Gerhardt had so many outs but was behind from the jump. And once again, the scorpion king knocks another player out as the lawnmower man once again mows down the competition and rakes in the chips. Gets another fatality. He is just the collector of bounty chips. All right, our blinds are now up to 200, 400. We are down to five players. Our dealer is Amazing Spidey. Small blind is the Doomslayer. Big blind is the Lawnmower Man, the Scorpion King. And first to act will be the Scorpion Queen, who quickly folds. Jurassic Jordan looks down at a pocket pair of nines, and he is going to raise all in. He's all in for 625. So the Doomslayer makes the call, but he is just short. He has 575. He is 50 short of the raise from the all-in bet of Jurassic Jordan. So right now we have two players who are all in, and Chris doesn't cost him anything. He has so many chips, he's going to make the call. So this pot is up to 1,600. We have three players. Two players are all in. Actually, the pot's up to 1,825. All right, so we have a pair of nines, jack eight suited, ace eight four suited. So we have hearts versus spades, and nines want to hold up and not see any overcards. He's only really worried about a jack. So he's in really good shape. He just has to dodge a jack and a run of hearts or spades. All right, we're just checking the side pot here. Did a little harder math than it needed to, but we do get it right. As the main pot will be 1725 and the side pot will be 100 for a total pot of 1825. So the pot between the Lawnmower Man and Jurassic Jordan is 100 and the main pot is 1725 in front of the Doomslayer. Again, we have two all ins at this in this call right here.
But I can't say no. I got two of you for 2.25 more. Always.
All right, so we're just double checking the count here, making sure we're good. This was an easier one, but we still want to make sure, right, especially after last year with a few times we've had side pot errors. So take our time, get this right, and we do.
Yeah, he's all in two. Yeah. Okay. Yes.
So they can flip their cards because there will be no more betting.
High card.
High, six, seven. There's six, seven.
Spade, six, king, king. So, all right, we have two kings on the board again. So we have a huge flush draw for the Doomslayer. Again, has four spades out there. He just needs one more spade to take this. Pretty much the Scorpion King is pretty much drawing dead. You have to have runner of an eight or a four to take this one down. Okay, so let's see what we got here. On the turn is a nine of spades. He catches his flush. Oh my goodness, is the Doomslayer lead? Let's check the table. Oh no, he's not. Jurassic Jordan now has a full house. Nines over kings. The only spade in the deck that would not help the Doomslayer was the nine of spades, and it comes out for a monster hand for Jurassic Jordan. Oh my goodness, we have a full house over a flush. Ridiculous. Oh my gosh, we have a full house nines over kings. Ugh. I think he's drawn dead, right? Just an insult to injury, another spade comes out. If that would have come out first, it would be more painful. So we have a survival from Jurassic Jordan and an elimination of the Doomslayer, who, even though he has a king high flush, gets eliminated. No one survives Jurassic Park. What a hand from Jurassic Jordan. And another drop dead Fred. KO for Jurassic Jordan. What a hand. What a tipsy-turvy way to get there. All right, the blinds are at 200, 400. We are down to four players now. Our dealer is the Lawn Mower Man, the Scorpion King, and small blind is a Scorpion Queen. Big blind is Jurassic Jordan. First to act is Amazing Spidey, who looks down at a pocket pair of eights. And it looks like he's going to make the call. The fold from the Scorpion King, a call from Scorpion Queen, and a call from Jurassic Jordan. So our pot's at the 1,200. The flop comes out 3-2 queen, all hearts. One overcard ahead of Amazing Spidey's pocket pair. We have a strong straight draw, though, from Alicia M, the Scorpion Queen. And first act here will be the Scorpion Queen. She checks her draw. Jurassic Jordan checks over to Amazing Spidey, who is in the lead. Has to be worried about two draws, hearts and a straight. Does he want to put his money in now to protect or not get caught up? He's going to make a decision here. I think he's going to want to see one more card for free to see if he can avoid the draws. And if he sees the draws get stronger, he can save some money. So a five comes out, making the straight draw even stronger. And now the Scorpion Queen has a pair of fives, but is still behind the pair of eights. Scorpion Queen will go first. Will she bet or check with her pair and still straight draw? She has an open-ended straight draw. She can get an ace or a six. And a two or a three or a five. Actually, no, the two or three won't help. So she bet 600. The Amazing Spidey put out 1,200 to raise the lead out bet. And the Scorpion Queen is going to call, but she was short. So the pot's up to 3,400. The Scorpion Queen is all in. Pair of fives versus a pair of eights. And an eight comes out to seal it. Once again, Amazing Spidey's pocket pair becomes a set. And he wins this one with a set of eights over a pair of fives. And he eliminates the Scorpion Queen, sending her off back out to the desert, where she will have to watch the rest of this tournament from the rail. Oh, Amazing Spidey and his pocket pairs just keep hitting. KO! All right, we are down to three players. We are on the bubble as there are two payouts for this tournament. We are still in the 200-400 blind level. Our dealer is Jurassic Jordan. Small blind is Amazing Spidey. Big blind is the Lawnmower Man, the Scorpion King. Oh no, he's big blind. Yeah, so first act will be Jurassic Jordan, who looks down at a Jack 8 offsuit. And it looks like he's going to raise all in. $825 all in. So it'll be Amazing Spidey was already in for 200. So it'll be $625 more to call to stay in. And he has pocket pairs of sevens. He's going to make the call. This pot's already up to 2,050. Pocket pairs have been good for Amazing Spidey all night long. We have a fold from the Lawnmower Man. So two players. Pots at 2,050. Two overcards, though, from the Jurassic Jordan is a jack and an eight. The flop comes out. Jack's the first card. Actually, let me pause. This is going so fast because I can't bet anymore. The flop was king, six, jack. So the jack comes out to take the lead with a pair of jacks. The turn is a king. So both players have two pairs, kings and sevens for Amazing Spidey versus kings and jacks for Jurassic Jordan. So Jurassic Jordan has a very strong chance to double up here once again. Oh, but the seven comes out on the river. Once again, Amazing Spidey's pocket pair becomes a set. And on the river, and this one actually becomes a full house. Sevens over kings. Oh my gosh. Amazing Spidey is living the good life as his pocket pairs become sets or stronger on all of these plays today. Unfortunately for Jurassic Jordan, he has been eliminated. He's been caught in Amazing Spidey's web.
I guess I was ahead to start with and went back and forth.
Oh, man. Tough turn of events. Fatality. tough turn of events for Jurassic Jordan. Oh my goodness. All right, so we have just come back from break. I'm going to pause it here just so I can catch my breath. All right, we've just come back from break. The blinds are at 250 and 500. We have two players left. Both these players will be in the money. The dealer is Amazing Spidey, so he is dealer and small blind and first to act on the pre-flop bet. And let's go from there. We have Alicia doing us the honors of dealing for us from the right side here, but Amazing Spidey has the dealer button. So he looks down at a king seven. Not a great hand, but a strong top card when you're playing heads up. So he raises here to 1,000. So it'll be 1,000 more to play, or 500 more to play. So Chris makes the call, and he has a queen eight of diamonds. So he is suited. Right now, the king is the top card. The queens, the diamonds are the better draw. Let's see what we get going on here. Here comes the flop. It is 4, 9, 6. There are two diamonds out there. So now Chris, the lawnmower man, has a king, queen high, diamond flush draw, while Amazing Spidey has a straight draw. Let's see. What does he need here? 4, 5, 6. He would need two cards, actually. So he's got a backdoor straight draw for Scorpion King, and he's got a super strong flush draw. First to act here will be Amazing Spidey. Amazing Spidey leads out with a $1,500 bet. Chris is reaching for chips as he likes his draws. He is behind at the moment, though, at least with the cards in the hand, and he makes the call. We have a pot of 5,000 going to the turn. A five. So now we have 4, 5, 6, 7. And now we have an open-ended straight draw for Amazing Spidey. He is still in the lead with a top card. The straight draw gets stronger as well, though, for the lawnmower man, as now he has, let's see, 4, 5, 6. He has a gut shot straight draw. He still has his flush draw. Amazing Spidey is in the lead with an open-ended straight draw, while the Scorpion King has a flush draw and a gut shot straight draw. Betting's over to Amazing Spidey. That's 2,000. He makes the call. Here comes the river. It is a seven of spades, giving Amazing Spidey a pair of sevens. However, the gut shot hits for the Scorpion King as he now has a straight. He caught the gut shot straight draw. He did not get the diamonds, but he got the gut shot straight draw here. Our pot is up to 9,000 right now. With that, the Scorpion King's going to lead out this time. He kept paying to see if he'd get his draws, and the draw came through. Can he get maximum extraction here?
What's that? 13.
So Chris Betts goes all in, which is way more than what Amazing Spidey has. If Amazing Spidey wants to call, it's going to be 1350, all of his chips. That seven's a killer card because it gave him just enough to catch a bluff. But he is behind as the straight hits, and the lawnmower man once again mows down the last player on the table, rakes in the final chips for a huge pot of 11,700, and we have our tournament victor today. And the final fatality of the match goes to the Scorpion King, sending Amazing Spidey off to the rail. The lawnmower man runs right through. Congratulations to Chris and the Scorpion King, a.k.a. the lawnmower man. Look at all those bounty discs. He had 7 bounty discs collected and or retained. Well done, sir, and congratulations. A big congratulations to the lawnmower man, Chris M., for taking this one down. Dating back to last season, he has now won two tournaments in a row. So with one tournament for this 2024 season in the books, let's take a look at the updated standings. All right. First place, we have Chris M. In second place, we have Michael F., Amazing Spidey. In third place, we have Jurassic Jordan. In fourth place, we have the Scorpion Queen, Alicia. In fifth place, we have the Doom Slayer, Steven S. And in sixth place, we have the Austrian Assassin, Gerhard. Do not forget that the top six players in the end of the season standings will earn a free seat into the WPL Invitational. All right, guys, now let's check in on the upcoming tournaments. All right, this is a look at our website here. So our next tournament will be the Wingman Poker Tournament number 2. This one will be 7 p.m. on Saturday, March 23rd. So just head over to the league website at wingmanentertainment.net/WPL. And on the website, you can see when the next tournament's going to be. Our league prize bank, and you can also go to the RSVP calendar to just go ahead and RSVP for the next tournament. See there, it shows your date. Your time, ask your name and email. Also in the middle section, we'll show you all the players that have already RSVP'd. You can take a look at the Bounty Hunt leaderboard and check the standings via the top of the page here. So please don't forget to RSVP using that RSVP calendar. You can also find our content on our new YouTube channel at youtube.com/@wingmanpoker.com or Wingman Poker. There you go. Sorry about that. All right, guys. So I want to thank you all again so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit that notification bell. Feel free to leave a comment on the league website or on the YouTube channel. So with all that being said, may your cards be live, your pocket aces hold, and we will see you next time.
Every time I think I'm out, they pull me back in.